For centuries, blacksmiths have shaped iron and steel. They have crafted boundless varieties of superior weapons to those of the past, along with tools and many other endless creations, never to be truly forgotten or erased from history. Starting with the Iron Age in 1200 BC and coming all the way up to the present day, blacksmiths have shaped not only iron and steel, but the future by breaking barriers in technology, culture, and metallurgy. They have done this by creating far superior tools to those used before with stone and bronze. With these tools, they can make weapons that certainly turn the tides in the battlefield and open the gate to more modern weapons as well. They also created steel that would change the world forever by providing a much stronger as well as hardenable material. These accomplishments are irreplaceable. One of the biggest things that blacksmiths broke barriers in was metallurgy and the science of forging. This not only helped blacksmiths in their craft, but it helped make way for the benefit of society both then and for years to come. The first main change was that of the material. Blacksmiths' iron and steel took the place of inferior metals such as stone and even bronze. Its combined strength, workability, and functionality in almost all tasks was and is incomparable. In the beginning, steel was created from blacksmiths raising the carbon content of wrought iron. Alex Steel demonstrates this perfectly when he uses a charcoal forge to melt iron that takes in carbon as it collects at the bottom. This process was first performed by the Hittites around the beginning of the Iron Age in 1200 BC. Another way of adding even more strength to already strong steel tools, weapons, etc. was the heat treatment process. This is the process by which steel is hardened and given temper for strength by quenching in oil, as demonstrated here. The next large barrier broken by blacksmiths was that of tools and technology. The blacksmith improved his own shop and capability with his own tools. These tools were used to make more tools and for other crafts and trades as well. Most all tools now and then can be in some way tied back to their roots at the forge. The blacksmith's tools are and were made with great care and skill. These tools often far outweigh other cheap or, in modern times, factory-made tools. In fact, during the Middle Ages, their work was of such great value that blacksmiths became a major asset, not only in castles, but in villages as workers to make and repair tools for local farmers and builders. John Deere was a much later example of this when he used his forging expertise to create the first steel plow that would replace the old iron ones. A third major barrier was weapons. Blacksmiths' hardened steel weapons were able to immensely increase performance, strength, and of course, efficiency on the battlefield when before they had used stone and bronze. These are some old stone spearheads. It is obvious that they are not very clean cut. They would also be much harder to keep sharp with the stone's brittle nature. And it is obvious that these steel swords and spearheads are much more cleanly cut and well-shaped due to the steel from which they were forged. Though they are corroded now, they would have worked a treat on the ancient battlefield. Some of the first steel weapons were actually arrowheads. These arrowheads could cut into enemies and eventually their armor, much better than the previously mentioned stone ones. Later on, Japanese swordsmiths perfected the art of making weapons. Their swords were known to be the best of all. Some say that they were so sharp they could decapitate an enemy as easily as a knife through butter. However, as time wore on, swords could no longer satisfy the demands for more death. The blacksmith's solution was guns. Though guns are now made in machines and are much more precise, the barrels and components were first forged by hand at the forge. One of the first to develop techniques in this kind of field was John Whitley. Some techniques he used were folding steel around a bar to be forge welded into a tube, as well as twisting strips of steel around a bar and welding them downwards. One final action to be performed by blacksmiths was their ways of satisfying the demands of culture. One very early example of blacksmiths being incorporated into human culture was the Greek god Hephaestus, god of the forge and other crafts. Blacksmiths also impressed the people with their ability to command all four elements of creation, as explained by Alex W. Beeler in The Art of Blacksmithing.
Fire, air, earth, and water were once considered the four elemental substances of our world. Among the ancients, only the blacksmith worked with all four. His forge held the fire, and his bellows controlled the air to his purpose. His material, iron, the black metal, was part of the earth, and water was essential to cool his heated iron and give temper to his red-hot steel.
So this makes us gods, right? Or not, but hey, it's cool anyway. On that note, blacksmiths were often asked to attend wedding ceremonies as well. This is because people believed that their ability to weld iron and steel at the anvil could also weld man and wife at the altar. As we have seen, blacksmiths have broken a great many barriers in the fields of metallurgy, tooling, weaponry, and culture. Their creations were the first of their kind, and many are still used today. Never would they have been discovered had the blacksmith not been there first to forge them from iron and steel. So in all truth, blacksmiths do not just break through barriers, they forge through them, as they forge their mark into history, legend, and science.